Then, pal, Wimbledon, centre court, home of all the greats. Becker, McEnroe, Connors, Borg.
I know, it's unbelievable, isn't it? I mean, even Schubacher got a game here.
No.
She did, I believe, a long time ago, but I think she got a game here. But can you believe it? Court 127. Come on.
Hello and welcome to Wimbledon on the opening day of the most famous tennis championships in the world. John and Ali have started their summer holidays with a game on one of the outside courts here. It could be a long match, so before we catch up with them, sit back and enjoy some of the best moments from the last series. George, it's your turn to go first. A number, please.
13.
I can see it's going to be a long night.
Correct. One.
Number one.
It's my wife.
I can think it'd be very quiet on the way home tonight, John.
Peter Nevin.
It is the national hunt jockey for 2 points.
I think it's got to be Nick Faldo. And I say that because he reminds me of Harrison Ford, does Nick Faldo.
And
why? I don't know, they've got the same mannerisms.
Right. Mm.
There's something about them that just look the same. And it's the type of thing he would do. Pull, you know. Jump over his shoulder. Jump over his shoulder.
I think there's a better chance of being Harrison Ford.
Go for Lee Westwood.
It's the 97 US Masters champion, Tiger Woods. It's the one in the distance.
Any one out of five will do fine.
You don't know what he's doing.
He's the Hawaiian sumo wrestler who's big in Japan. Pardon the pun.
Not just there, I think.
I know, I used
he's to got watch. A famous
it's
nickname, I'll accept.
Yeah.
It's Ron Atkinson.
He's got to keep it up.
There's no gold out of here, he hasn't got any gold in.
Can't be big, Ron.
It's like Ron.
He does Yokozuna and all that. And what's it? I used to watch that.
Did you?
Whenever he felt fat, he used to watch that, you know? And then have a sandwich afterwards.
You won't believe it, the wee guy at the front actually wins it because you can't see it, just out of camera shot, he's got a cannon. He just lights it and says, have some of this, big boy. Blam. He's got a serious cheek to wear a sweatband on his wrist. Hasn't he? That's probably the only place in that body that doesn't sweat.
Oh.
Can't think of his name.
No. It's on offer.
We think it's something like... Takahashi.
No.
Takahashi? That's a microwave.
It's kind of cheeky. Oh.
That's it.
I think it's Schumacher.
There's two.
Pun?
There's two of them.
No, there's only one. I'll give you a point. There's two if I go like that.
There's Michael Laird and Ralph there.
No,
if I go like that, there's only one.
Very cruel. Go on, Tony, you know who it is.
It's Michael, isn't it?
It is Michael Schumacher.
Scottish widows.
We should get it.
If you don't know who it is, good. Sue?
She knows, she's got answers for me.
Are we close?
Well, I think we've been friends for years, yeah.
And the answer to your next question is yes.
Oh, dear.
Liverpool player. Defender. It's not. Harkness.
No, it isn't.
Oh. Harry Kewell.
2 points.
You did well.
Ali, your team have got the funny side of sport. We need you to name the athlete who doesn't hear a full start and keeps running, and the tennis player who wins a point serving underarm.
My getting will be trying to regain a little bit of lost prestige in this match. Oh. A false start now. And the crowd teller.
One who keeps tearing around.
Can we get on with the game now? I'm starting to molt.
Memories, John, was that?
Delightful. There was a parrot inside that cat.
Oh. Very slow. Right.
Who was the sprinter, Don?
Merlin Ari.
Yes.
Michael Chang.
Michael Chang, yes. Both points.
Well done, guys.
John, your team are looking on the bright side. Okay. Who's the goalkeeper totally deceived by Steve McManaman and the rugby player who just can't get the ball down for a try?
They can really make you mad. Other things just make you swear. When you're chewing on last whistle, that grumble, give a whistle. This'll help things turn out for the best. And always look on the bright side of life. Always look on the light side of life. If life seems jolly rotten, there's something you've forgotten. And that's to laugh and smile and dance and sing. When you're feeling in the dumps, don't be silly chumps. Just purse your lips and whistle. That's the thing.
Hey.
She thinks it's an ice cream.
So, first of all, the goalkeeper?
Ian Walker.
And the rugby player who couldn't get the ball down for a try?
Will Carling.
Yep, both points. Ali, your team has got golf and the Players' Championship in Florida. American Brad Fable on the 17th. What happened next?
Patrick Duffy, the man from Atlantis, comes out the water.
Excuse me, this is one of the more believable ones.
There's ducks or something, there's... there's animals.
Fish.
And then birds and fish.
Wildebeest. And then rhinos.
Some type of bird walks onto the putting green as they're about to putt, and they have to...
Yep.
Get rid of it.
I need a bit more than that.
What's the point, though? I would have thought.
What was the bird then?
What was the bird like? Well, she was.
I'm surprised you can move.
It's not my cup of tea, but she was OK.
The bug came on and took the ball.
And took, actually, lifted it. It's amazing.
What did you just say?
Lifted the ball.
Yes. It flew off with it. This was it?
To be fair, I just laid it. Oh.
I think Mr. Rossetti is going to get fed up of having aces served past him all the time.
No, I think the ball hit.
Go on, Jenny, get them some. Yes. Get them some, Jenny.
They're quite clearly indoors, I think. And I think that ball, when it hit really hard, because you just see it shoot right up in the air, and I think it's stuck up there somewhere.
That's a very good try, but we're not going with that one.
That's it.
Something must be happening down here.
So you're going to go for that one?
You're the captain.
Well, don't ask me, because I can't remember last night.
No, you might be wrong, and then... we think the ball's got stuck up there somewhere.
But sadly, Jenny, it isn't right, so it does go over to the other side.
Can I ask the question again, Sarah?
Yeah. We just need to know what happened next.
What happened next?
Rearrange this well-known phase.
What happened
next? Next, what happened?
What's wrong with you from her? Because I don't understand you.
I work with him and I don't understand
him. In English, please, in English.
What would you have done then? Come on.
Well, I'll pull my pants down. But what I do, I will serve in three aces myself after.
No, not close. This is what happened. Greg did, in fact, get fed up with being ace so much.
Yeah, yeah.
He decided he needed a rest, needed some help, so he handed the racket to the ball girl, Victoria Lister. And while he sits down, she plays the longest rally of the match with Richard Krajicek.
And she won.
Ali, you've got cricket. For 1 point, you have to give the name of the Sri Lankan bowler who took 16 English wickets at the Oval this year.
Ramatanga Gali. I can't. Stop. I know it's Ram.
For your second point, Ramatang. You have to spell it.
All I know is Ramatanga. It's R A M A. Plenty of letters.
Rama what?
Ramatagulga.
Yeah, that's right.
No, it isn't. Come on,
Chappers. Actually, you're quite close, because that name was an anagram of the real one.
Yeah. Mullerithoran.
Yep.
Oh, that was close, eh?
And John knows how to spell it.
Come on, Moo.
Yeah.
Moo.
M-U.
The only thing we know is
Moo-ra.
M.
Moo-rah. Moo-rah. Moo-rah.
It's Sesame Street. Yes. M-U-R, you're right. Yes.
So that's, hold on, what have we got here?
Mura.
M-U-R-A.
Mura.
Mura. Li.
Li.
Mura. Mura. Li. I.
Yes.
We're not even halfway through. Oh, God, we're going over.
But it's going so well. Lift. Lift.
T-H.
Yes.
Oran.
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 Oran. Oran.
Oran. Oran. Oran.
Oran.
R-A-N.
Yes! Which current Manchester United player scored a goal that helped knock them out of the 94-95 European Champions League?
Not a clue.
He thinks I know nothing about football.
There's three of us. Can I phone a friend? Blomqvist.
Yes, but Blomqvist in a 3-1 victory for Gothenburg. You are right. Ali, for you it's darts. What is the fewest number of darts you would need to score 1,000 finishing on a double?
I'm going to burn up here. Here, stick your game.
Can someone bring me a cup of tea?
Please. Right, go on then.
17.
Yep, 16 treble 20s and a double. Well, 20. Done, boys. Richard Raskin played in the men's singles at the 1960 US Open. Renee Richards reached the final of the ladies' doubles at the 1977 US Open. What do Richard and Renee have in common?
It was one and the same person.
What would that be in common?
They're related, no?
I need more.
Oh.
Well, his father and his mother met in 1945. The cheeky wee wine bar on the outskirts of Manhattan, right? Father and daughter.
No, it isn't. It goes over to the other side.
Brother and sister.
No.
Auntie and great-uncle.
They are the same person. Richard became Renee in 1976. And I was in the shower with him. Her, I mean. That's a story for another time.
It's not what I want to hear, by the way. He keeps saying, I ain't got a clue, mate, and he's drawing. He's doing his technical drawing and he keeps going, I ain't got a clue, mate. He got CFAX and Teletext. Adrian Maguire.
Spot on. Oh, they left him there.
He just said, well done, mate. Who is that, by the way?
The winner of the 98 Whitbread Gold Cup.
By the way, John's had a police meeting.
Go on, David.
No, no, you.
No.
It's been a setup from start to finish. I'm not happy. No, I refuse.
Please.
Steve Collins.
It may not sweetest voice, but you certainly wouldn't argue with him. It is Steve Collins, and he sings it for us one more time. Listen to this. Go on, Steve, go for it. The sweetest thing.
Have we won? Is that it?
Two more rounds to go.
Oh,
Jimmy.
Dear me.
Ali fancies she won.
Does he?
I knew it. It's come out now.
It is the great Australian spinner, Shane Warne.
Very good. Yeah. Leo too.
That's if you stop there, it could be 3021.
Oh, is that where he had to in the window?
I think that is Bernie Slaven.
2 points, well done.
That'll be that big roar then. He's not lifting very much though, is he? I mean, yeah.
Actually, he's not lifting anything. That's the dado rail behind him.
He's Polish, isn't he? Polish. The Polish roar.
No, it isn't. So over it goes, Steve. Oh.
Sat behind me for the last 2 years. Twice world champion, James Cracknell.
2 points.
Are you sure that's not that actor?
Yeah, it is. I'll go for that.
That's who I think it is. Why do you and I think it's the same person and he hasn't got a clue and yet he's agonising?
Because why would it be an actor on a sports quiz?
Those two could get up to anything.
Excuse me, well, you are.
John.
Honestly, no. Not got a clue. Go on.
Well, we might as well get it wrong as not have a guess, because you've got to have a go, haven't you?
Go on.
Go on, have a go.
Go on, Jenny, go on.
Well,
go for
you
it.
You get it wrong, not me.
It's all. OK. Dwight York. I'm going to have a look. He looks like him.
I think it's only fair that I go to the other team after that.
I'm going for Bill Athey of Yorkshire.
Who played 23 times that. For England. It's yeah! In!
I like Dwight York better.
Do you know what? He went then, he left Yorkshire.
We don't care.
Oh, shut up!
Dickie, shut up. So on to the final round, and you've got to be very quick here. It's the buzzer round. Anyone can press. Do you want to just try your little... Yeah. Oh, that's John's the bell, and Ali, you're the...
Hey, believe me, he doesn't need a buzzer either.
How come I've got a cash register? It's like, yeah, I'm free!
You've got absolutely no chance of winning that.
I think he looks more like Mrs. Slager, doesn't he?
Football, the longest serving Premiership manager.
Jim Smith.
No, Alex Ferguson.
No, I mean, he's longer than... I thought he meant all over. You can't say that. You're meant all over. You've got 50 odd That's a dodgy question.
Which team knocked Manchester United out of last year's FA Cup? Ali.
Barnsley.
Well, yes. Done, Ali.
You should have got it from Barnsley.
You were too quick for me there. I got it.
Golf. Which Briton won his third US Masters title? Ali. Ali.
No, it wasn't me.
Nick Faldo.
I get beat. I don't mean
one
the
point
cut.
Away. Rugby league. Which scrum half? Good luck.
What?
Which scrum? You half? Had rugby league. Which scrum half when you buzzed?
We go. The week four. Rugby league scrum half, famous one. Quick.
Sean. Quick.
Sean Edwards. Sean Edwards.
Yes! Okay, moving on. Tennis, where is the French Open held? Robbie.
Paris.
Right, though.
Need the name, need the menu.
Oh, Roland Garros.
Yes! Oh, there you was, Jess. Got to be quicker.
Roland Garros.
Football.
Viewers in black, white back home. We'll go through it again.
Roland Garros.
Which sports world championships have been held at Jolly's nightclub?
Darts.
Oh.
No, he's just.
You said that too.
That's unbelievable. Because I was going to say chess, but I'll say darts now.
Youngest winner of the Wimbledon men's singles.
Boris Becker.
Yes. Cricket. The England batsman who scored 333 in... Ali.
Graham Gooch.
Yes. Athletics. The British high jump record. Ali.
Steve Smith.
Yes.
Oh, I'm going home.
It's a stupid round, then.
In which sport would you use a spider? Matt.
Snooker.
Yes. Who's the European? Great stuff. Now, John and Ali have been out on court 127, and I have a feeling I need to get down there quickly to the umpire's chair to restore some order. Hope you've enjoyed the series, and we'll be back for a new one in the autumn. Cheerio.
Unhurried.
For 2 weeks every summer, one tournament grips the nation unlike any other. Join us on television and radio as Wimbledon comes alive with BBC Sport tomorrow.